first went to Afghanistan in the spring of 2002. It was a time when the war was considered over or just ended. And I kind of went there on a whim, really. I was traveling between India and Tibet, and I decided to make a little detour that I thought would take a couple of weeks, and it ended up taking up the rest of my life. So that was about 10 years ago. I think what I reacted to at first was it was a place that was physically totally devastated. The city of Kabul was just lying in ruins, and it's set against this totally epic backdrop of these incredible mountains and a really stark but very beautiful landscape. But in the middle of this really harsh landscape were people who, despite the circumstances, were incredibly optimistic for a moment. I mean, they'd just been coming out of a really brutal period, 8 years of Taliban rule, and a far longer period of really brutal civil war. I've traveled around this region by every conceivable means. I've walked for hundreds of miles, I've ridden horses, I've traveled in jeeps and trucks, helicopters and armored vehicles. I don't think there's any means of transportation I haven't taken across this region. Over time, I guess I've become part of the fabric, whether I'm embedded with a military unit or whether I'm living amongst some nomadic group of herders in some remote valley or mountainside in Afghanistan or Pakistan. I think people tend not to notice me so much when I'm working. Sometimes the photographs are the product of a long interaction that breeds some kind of familiarity and trust, and sometimes it's just a fleeting moment. For years now, the United States, NATO partners have maintained a huge number of troops in Afghanistan. Supplying those troops is a mind-bending logistical exercise, which accounts for some of the really difficult to believe price tags that you hear. At the height, the United States was spending something like $10 billion a month in Afghanistan on military operations alone. That goes into moving everything from food and water and ammunition, weapons and vehicles. It is pretty much the biggest logistical operation that the United States or Western militaries have undertaken since World War II. And it's incredibly costly. I mean, some of the photographs that I show a lot are of the most vulnerable populations in this region and across Afghanistan and Kashmir and Pakistan, and that is the refugees, the displaced, and among them women and children. And I think beyond this image that we constantly see in newspapers and magazines of radical, enraged jihadis, who are supposed to pose, this mortal threat to the outside world. I hope people will also consider the vast majority of the population that doesn't fit that stereotype at all. For years, the challenge has been not just to make photographs, but how to figure out ways to share them and put them anywhere other than the pages of newspapers and magazines. So if they can be seen in stores, if they can be seen in places where people walk into an environment who had no intention of seeing or learning anything about Afghanistan or Pakistan or any other subject, I'm interested in trying to experiment with ways to share the photographs or to share the stories around them or to use them to try to trigger conversations that I hope will get towards making some kind of impact. Because ultimately, the only purpose of the photographs is to engage people and to make them have conversations around them that might lead to some change.